Volcanoes. Canada has approximately 24 of them. Yes, you heard me correctly. And altogether, they have produced 6 eruptions during only the last 500 years. These occurred in 1590, 1600, 1700, 1800, possibly 1898, and 1904. And yet, despite one of these eruptions being directly witnessed by Klondike gold rush miners in 1898, absolutely none of Canada's volcanoes are adequately monitored per standards suggested by scientists. In fact, the system which has produced the most definably volcanic earthquakes in the last 50 years, aka Mount Meager, only reaches the level of monitoring deemed a minimum for the very lowest threat category of volcanoes in the nation, such as the Toya volcanic field, which has a nearby population of 0. As a reminder, Mount Meager produced a powerful explosive eruption the same magnitude as the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens only 2400 years ago, causing ash to fall as far away as Calgary and Banff and sending lethal lahars to as much as 80 kilometers away. Today, 4700 people live within potential striking distance of a similarly sized eruption were one to occur. As for the other 27 volcanoes, they only have enough monitoring equipment to detect swarms of non-microquake magnitude earthquakes, and not every volcano before an eruption produces events of that magnitude. As you might have guessed, this lack of equipment is woefully inadequate. Hypothetically, a magmatic intrusion could be underway right now at 27 of Canada's 28 volcanoes, and there is a chance that we would not know about it beforehand 100% of the time until an eruption began and ash started to fall. However, this could change if the following equipment is placed at each volcano: a dozen seismometers, at least 3 GPS stations, several gas level monitoring sensors, a web camera, tilt meters, and stream sensors to detect the amount of flow and temperature of water in drainages surrounding a volcano along with any gases within it. Placing monitoring equipment at volcanoes is incredibly important, with one reason being it gives you an idea of what a volcano's baseline is, which varies from system to system. To see how much of a potential problem the current lack of equipment could cause, let me give you a real-world example which occurred last year. On September 2nd of 2023, I was sent a video clip by a local helicopter pilot seemingly showing a brand new fumarole producing gas that rose more than 100 meters into the air at a section of the Garibaldi Lake volcano. This feature had not existed beforehand, and the appearance of it could have meant that magma was suddenly shallower than it was beforehand. I thus contacted the relevant geological agency with what I had been showed. The agency was quite competent and knew what they were doing, but didn't have the data to quickly get back to me due to a lack of sufficient monitoring equipment. And this is at the nation's third most dangerous volcano, which is within striking distance of 16,000 people. It took until the following day for a regular helicopter pilot the agency had contacted to report back on the apparent fumarole, confirming that what was observed was merely a temporary burst of windblown dust and not a change at the volcano. While this was thankfully a false positive, some volcanoes can change quite rapidly in a matter of hours, in which case, if this had been an actual warning sign of rising magma, the volcano hypothetically, well, quite unlikely, could have already erupted by then. However, there is another problem when it comes to Canada's volcanoes. We don't actually know enough about existing complexes in the nation. For example, we don't know when the two cinder cones adjacent to the town of Atlin, population 500, erupted other than sometime twice in the last 11,650 years. Or, at Mount Aziza, there likely were 30 eruptions in the last 11,650 years, yet we only know the ages of 4 of these. Without knowing the ages of all of these, scientists cannot identify if any patterns or clusters of activity occur, if there is a repetitive cycle of activity that lasts a certain amount of time that we could hypothetically be in, and other factors. And that 1898 eruption that I mentioned earlier, we actually don't know which volcano produced it, assuming it did occur as reported in a local newspaper. You do see the potential problem with all of these issues. While I sincerely doubt that any Canadian volcano would unexpectedly erupt or unexpectedly generate fatalities through such an event, a very low risk of these scenarios does exist. However, this risk will be greatly reduced if sufficient and proper monitoring equipment is placed in studies of multiple volcanoes in the countries are made.